Hi everyone, I'm Cody, W3AMG with BridgeCom Systems, and today we're going to be showing you how to update the firmware on your AnyTone mobile radio. Today we're going to be using the AnyTone ATD578UV3+, the latest and greatest one, but this should apply to the previous ones and the future ones as long as you get the right firmware. So let's get started. First thing we're going to do is take our programming cable. We're going to plug one end into the computer. And next, we're going to plug the other end of that into the radio itself. Just like that, there's a port on the side here. Sometimes it can be a pain to open up that rubber flap, but once you do, you can plug in the cable. And this time, we are ready to put the radio into firmware update mode. Now, the way you do this, if you're familiar with the handheld, it's going to be a little bit different. Okay, so all you have to do to put the radio into firmware update mode is press down the menu, the exit, and the power button. We're gonna hold them down, make sure the radio is turned on. We're gonna hold them down until this light here starts flashing. So here we go. We'll hold all three of them down and wait for that light. I believe we should be okay to release at this point. There you go. That light's gonna start flashing. So once you hold them down and turn it off that way, when you release, it's gonna start that light flashing and the radio is now in firmware update mode. So now that we have it plugged in, we can move over here to the computer on the CPS. So go ahead and open up your programming software. If you don't have that installed, we do have another video that will show you how to do that. Once you're here, what you'll do is go up to Tool. Actually, first, we're gonna make sure the radio is connected. So click on the COM port button. You'll find it in between the read and the write buttons right here. Click on that, make sure it's selected, which it is. And now go to Tool and Firmware Upgrade. Now, if you're on a Windows computer that has a lot of applications, you might not see it. So just click one of these arrows here. There we go. It looks like it popped up. So click on that and just click yes. Now at this point, we need to install the update file. So we're gonna open that file. If you just downloaded your CPS or firmware, it actually comes with the update file that you need. So we're gonna go here, the version we just downloaded for the 578, the 2.02, that actually comes with the firmware file. So click on firmware, this version right here, inside of the file that you get. If you don't have this, just go to our website, bridgecomsystems.com, click on support, and you can download it there. So we'll open that up. It's going to be an SPI file, what you're looking for, and just click open. There we go, file open success. Awesome, so we are pretty much ready. Just go ahead and click write and click okay. Now at this point, it may take a few minutes. It's going to update the firmware on that radio. After that, you're gonna be all good to go. What I would recommend doing before you do this procedure, make sure you write or read from your code plug on your computer and save that code plug just in case anything happens. Always wanna make sure you have a backup. And some updates, depending on the update, actually want you to reinitialize the radio, in which case you definitely will need a backup. So it's always a good idea to do that first. Awesome, there we have it, is complete. So at this point, we should be good to unplug everything. So we can unplug our programming cable, just like that, and wait for that radio. I think we have to turn it on. We'll boot it back up and we can verify if it actually worked. There we go, awesome. So at this point, just go into the menu and we'll go down to settings. There you go, settings. Go to device info. And there we go, firmware version 2.02. So it did work, we are ready, and this radio is now up to date.